Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today is going to be my first month check-in for my 2021 low buy. If you didn't know, I am doing a low buy. I will leave my introductory video linked in the cards and down below for you. That's where I explain kind of my motivation, the rules I have, all that kind of stuff. So this is the first month that I embarked on this journey, and I have a whole page in my notebook here of things that I document throughout the month that I'd like to share with you. I am also going to be leaving different timestamps down below for the different sections of this video if you're more interested in one or the other. But I really appreciate you taking some time out of your day to tune in and watch this video, and let's go ahead and jump right in, shall we? I'm going to start with the purchases I made in January because I think that's kind of like a big thing to talk about. And I had three separate purchases that I made throughout the month. Now, before I show you and talk through each of these things, I want to remind you what my budgets are. So I have two different budgets that I'm really tracking for this series. One is for clothing and one is for beauty. My clothing budget, I decided on $500 for the entire year. This includes any sort of replacement items, any wants, just $500 for clothing type items. For beauty, I'm doing $50 a month. So really it's gonna be $600 for the whole year. But I started off with actually $50.03 because I have that money in a high interest savings account. So I do earn a little bit of interest on it, which bonus. So I actually started the year off with $50.03, but that's neither here nor there. So I'm going to go through the like month kind of chronologically and when I made these purchases. So the first purchase I made was on January 6th. So I didn't even make it a full 7 days, but it was a replacement item. Something that I needed to replace in my makeup collection was a concealer. So I have had this, well, I guess I had the kind of sister to this. This is the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer. I had the regular camo concealer, but it was in a shade that was way too light for me, which I am a very fair, pale person. So for it to be like too light on me was actually pretty astonishing. So I got rid of that one, and I needed a new concealer to use on like blemishes, and I can also use this under my eyes. So I picked up the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer because I heard that this one's better than the regular camo concealer, even if you have oily skin, which I have. And I got the shade Fair Beige, which this fits my, you know, complexion way better. So this cost me $6, and I got this at Target when I was doing a run for a few other things for the house and stuff like that. I decided to just swing through and pick this up. And there's a ton of product in here, and it also has this giant doe foot applicator, which I think is kind of fun. So I'm really pleased with it. It's been working out for me. And yeah, this cost me $6 from Target. Then on the 22nd of January, so I went a couple of weeks, I placed an Ulta order. And there's a couple of reasons for this. There were two things that after filming my makeup collection, which I can leave up in the cards and down below for you, I realized I had a gap that I really wanted to fill, and that was in the blush category. I currently have two blushes in my makeup collection because I have a pretty small and curated collection, and they're both very similar in color and tone. They're both more pinky, rosy, which I like. However, I've really been wanting a peach toned blush to wear, especially just with different looks, different things that I'm wearing, and I really like it for this spring as well. So I was kind of on the hunt for a peach blush, and I also have fallen in love with an eyeshadow palette that I just could not get out of my head. I've had this one in my head for about 6 weeks now, so it's not like an impulsive purchase necessarily, but so I decided, you know what, let me just go onto Ulta's website, poke around, see what I can find, and I ended up finding a few things and actually ordering them. Now, when I logged into my Ulta account, I found out I had 500 points that were going to be expiring very soon. And 500 points at Ulta equates to $17.50, which is a decent amount of money, you know? I'm not gonna be placing some giant order, but I was pleased to see that. So I figured, you know what? Let me use these credits while I can. And I also had on that day a 20% off your entire order at Ulta coupon come through. So like, check, check, check all the boxes. And then I went on to Mr. Rebates. I have my link down below. It's a referral link if you're wondering. It's kind of like Rakuten Ebates, but I find that Mr. Rebates is always higher. So that's where I go. But anyway, they had like 5% back. It was just like all the stars aligned. And so I made a purchase. So what I got is I got my peach blush. This is from ColourPop and it's the shade Fresh and Peachy. And it's a matte peach blush, which I love. It is so beautiful. I really like the consistency. I like how it wears on my cheeks. And I'm just really, really pleased with it. And ColourPop, of course, is a pretty affordable brand. So I was happy to get this. And then I also got the palette that I've really been wanting, which is also from ColourPop. And this is the Wild Nothing, which is kind of like cactus themed, which love that. And these are the shades. So it's a really soft, kind of corally orange neutral palette, which is, all I have is neutral palettes. But I was really intrigued for this palette for two reasons. The first one is this green eyeshadow, which I don't know if it's really pulling as green here or not, but I would say it's like a entry-level green because it's kind of like a gold green. It's not like, whoa, that's lime green eyeshadow. It's very, very subtle and flattering and kind of just a twist on a regular eye look that I would do. The other reason that I was really interested in this is because there's two Super Shock eyeshadows in here. This one right here and this one over here. And I've actually never used a Super Shock eyeshadow, which everybody I feel like has used at this point, but I'm just late to that train and I've always been curious. So it seemed like this was a good fit for the variety, for the green, for the Super Shock eyeshadows, for the beautiful palette itself. And I decided to pick it up. This palette's normally $18, so that's $17.50 from my Ulta credits basically covers this. Of course, it's split out across the other products I bought, but this is the palette. Then I also picked up two nail polishes. I have it in my head this year that I kind of want to weed out my nail polishes. I have a lot of old nail polishes. And they are starting to dry up. I'm having to decide, you know what, this one isn't performing anymore. No matter how much thinner I put in, it's just not working. So these are the two that I picked up. They're both very springtime colors, which I think are beautiful year-round. So I got these both from the brand Zoya, which is one of my favorite nail polish brands. The purple here is in the shade Abby. And this pink here, which is like a nice bubblegum pink, is Missy. So I also picked these up my coupon and credits and all that applied. So these four items from Ulta after everything, I actually got free shipping on it, but with taxes and everything involved, cost $21.88. So I was pretty pleased with that. I think that's a good steal for me. And I, stand by the purchase I made. I don't plan to order a new eyeshadow palette every single month by any means. It was just something that kind of came up and the opportunity presented, so I took it. Okay, and then on the 24th of this month, I ordered a new workout top. So this is a long sleeve top. I got it off of Amazon. I actually have another one from the exact same brand that I bought in December, and I've really been enjoying it. So it's just a nice long sleeve, very thin material. It wicks all the moisture away. This is the navy color, but I have a light blue as well. So this cost $11.95 off of Amazon, and I stand by this purchase. I've already been using it and wearing it. I'm doing a workout challenge, so I'm working out 4 to 5 days a week, and it's really nice to have the long sleeve option just because it's winter in Minnesota and I'm still working out inside, but it's nice to just have that extra layer, on. So those were my three purchases, and let's do a little recap of the budget now. So I started the month for beauty with $50.03. I spent between my concealer and my Ulta order $27.88. Which means that I ended the month at $22.15. Now I add to this fund, I would say, each month. So I did already get my, February paycheck, and I did add in the $50. So now I have $72.15 going into the month of February if I choose to use it. For my clothing, I have a set budget of $500 a year. I spent $11.95 on that workout top. So now I have $488.05 remaining in that budget. The other thing I wanted to mention is the extra money that I was able to put to debt. So I actually will have my budget recap video up very shortly here on my channel. But one of the reasons why I want to do a low buy is I really want to pay off my credit cards. I have two remaining with balances. And I actually almost knocked one out completely this month. I was able to put 2,000 $54.29 towards that credit card, which there's a lot of reasons. I had a lot of extra income come through in January, which again, I'll talk about in that other video. I'll link it as soon as that one's up. I think it's coming up after that I post this one. But nevertheless, that's a lot of money I was able to put towards that. And that was my primary focus. I could have absolutely bought so much more stuff from Ulta, but I reined it in. I stayed within my budget and I'm really, really pleased with that. The next section of this video that I want to talk about are just some of the feelings I'm having. I'm feeling really abundant with the number of things. I have a good backstash and, you know, things that I have at home that I can go through and use up before I really need to purchase replacements, which is really nice. And I'm excited because it's exciting to finish something else up and then get to go into the closet and pick something else new. You know, I finished up a facial moisturizer this month and I was so excited to go, okay, well, here are the different facial moisturizers. Which one do I want to pick next? And it was just a really fun experience to shop your own stash and to have that motivation continue forward of, I want to use up what I have. I want to be grateful for what I have and I don't want to waste what I have. Another thing is I ripped one of my pair of PJ pants to the point that they cannot be repaired. They're just too torn up. And I'm also just pleased that I decided, you know, I don't want to replace them. I have other PJ pants. I've got leggings. I've got sweatpants I can wear in the place. I don't need to replace this pair of PJ pants. And that was kind of a mind shift for me that just because something was worn out or it's considered done doesn't mean that I have to replace it. I can still decide if I want to or not. And that was an instance that I decided I don't want to replace this. I'll just keep going with what I have. Something else is in the middle of the month, I had a doctor's appointment, which I ended up needing to go to Target to fill a antibiotic prescription. And so while I was waiting for that prescription to be filled, I, you know, had to wander around Target until they told me that they were done. And I was pretty proud of myself because I went through, you know, I went through the clothing section, I went through the jewelry section, I went through the beauty section, and nothing urged me to think, ooh, I want that. Nothing. And that was a really cool feeling because I already had it made up in my mind. I'm only coming in here. I'm only going to buy my prescription and I'm getting out of here. Like that. When I walked into Target, that's what I wanted to do and that's what I did. So I'm pretty proud of that as well because Target is definitely one of those places that can just suck you in and all of a sudden you're leaving the store and you don't even know what's in your cart. So this month I felt pretty accomplished with what I was able to do as far as curbing my spending habits. And I also was able to finish up a few things in my collection. I'm going to be filming empties videos every other month. So there was not an empties video this month, but there should be one in February for you guys to watch if you want to hear the reviews of the products. But I was able to finish up 2 makeup products, 1 skincare product, and 2 body products this month of January. A lot of my skincare is really close to being finished up, which I'm very excited for because I do have backups for most of them. I do have 2 items that I will need to repurchase for a replacement. That is my eye serum that I use in the morning time. I use the Ordinary Caffeine EG, whatever that is, serum. I love that and I do not have a backup. I don't even have a backup of another eye cream or something else that I could use. So that is something I will be purchasing, and thankfully the Ordinary is a very inexpensive brand. And I also need a retinol product for my face. I have 1 use left out of the retinol product I have right now, and then I've got a sample that I'm estimating will probably last me 2, maybe 3 uses, but there's not a ton in there. So when I get the Ordinary eye serum, I also plan to pick up a retinol product. So I think I'm going to order from Sephora and get the Inky List retinol. There's a 1-ounce retinol, I think, for $10 that I think I would like to try. That seems like a good price point. I use retinol once or twice a week. It rotates through my skincare. Anyway, those are 2 that I foresee being purchases in February, but both of those are inexpensive brands that definitely will not break my $72.15 beauty budget that I have going on. So that is something I can see going on in the future. I wouldn't say that those are necessarily like wish list items because those are replacements, but maybe. Other wish list items though that I want to mention, I've been really, really wanting a cream bronzer, but I can't tell if I actually want it because I want it, or if I want it because I'm seeing so many other people use them. So I'm going to hold off until I can even answer that question on my own, right? That's kind of a red flag to me that, well, you don't know why you want to buy something, so you probably shouldn't buy something. Another thing is olive nail polish. So I was just kind of telling you that my nail polishes are getting old. My very favorite olive green nail polish. I can't even open the bottle anymore. It's so dried out. So that is something that's going to be on my wish list. I typically lean towards olive greens more in the fall. So I don't see myself really purchasing that anytime soon, but it's going to be something that I have the time then to research and figure out what brand I want to go through, what shades, because I am kind of particular on this actual shade of olive green. And the one that I have is long discontinued. I can't just repurchase it. So that's something that's going to be on my wish list for a while because I don't want to like prematurely buy it, right? Like I would rather wait till, okay, now it's the fall when I would wear this shade. Now I can purchase it. I don't want to be purchasing it now because I'm not drawn to that color of nails until the fall. Anyway, also the Bite lip glosses. I've been seeing positive reviews of those, and I love a good lip gloss. I currently have two lip glosses in my collection. I think that's where I'd like it to be. I have the NYX Butter Gloss and I have the Fenty Gloss Balm. So whenever I finish one of those up, then I probably will replace with the Bite lip gloss, but I don't foresee that happening for a while yet. Like I said, I don't really want more than two lip glosses in my collection right now. I'm very pleased with that number because it's, you know, easy and sustainable. And it feels like I definitely can use both of those up in the amount of time before they expire. So I don't plan to buy that now, but if I could finish up a lip gloss, that would be the one that I would want to try next. Then two clothing items that I'm wanting. One is for the summertime, so not quite yet, but I am going to want to buy a new swimsuit for the summer. I bought a swimsuit last summer that I loved and I wore to death. I still can wear it. It's not like unusable, but I am losing weight, which is great. So I'm not sure it will like fit as properly. So as summer gets closer, I probably will evaluate purchasing a new swimsuit that will fit better for me this summer. I personally prefer a one piece, but without straps. I like a bandeau top one piece, if that makes sense. So I'll probably just purchase off of Amazon. I might even just purchase the swimsuit I bought last year off of Amazon, but in a smaller size, but that is something that's on my radar of potentially needing and wanting. But again, I will wait until the season is appropriate because it is February and I live in Minnesota and there's no way I'm going outside in a swimsuit right now. And then the last thing that's on my wish list right now is I would like to repurchase one of the sweatshirts I have in my collection, but in another shade. I bought this like really cute fuzzy sweatshirt. It's kind of like velour, and I really love it. It's one of my favorite things to wear, and I'm really kind of wanting a second color, but that is truly just a want. So I'm going to probably sit on that for a while, you know, maybe see in the fall or something if I still want that, but old me probably would have already bought it, and that's why I'm putting it on this list and in this video to kind of explain that I am changing my habits, and these are things that had come up that I stopped myself from buying. So those are the big things. Something else I just thought of that I probably will purchase in February is a new pack of socks. My socks are getting lots and lots of holes in the bottom to the point where I don't think I have a full set that match without holes. So I think I probably will buy a six pack or something of ankle socks to replace those ones with the holes in them. But past that, I think we talked about the skincare products and socks, and I don't think there's anything else I can think of right now that I really would want or need to purchase in February. So we'll just see how the month goes. I, of course, will update you in my check-in video at the beginning of March how I did, but that is going to be it for me and my low buy. If you're doing something similar, I would love to hear your update down below. What were your successes? Were there any struggles that you may have had? You know, I wouldn't say that I had a lot of struggles throughout the month. It's just been something I'm having to remind myself, you're on a low buy. And, it's a rewiring of your brain. It's not going to come naturally and easy, but I think as the year goes on, it will become more of a habit. So anyway, I'm going to stop rambling. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in my next one.